An ode to the number 10. 10 is the number of fingers on my hands. 10 is the number of toes on my feet. And the number of 10 cent coins in a dollar. And 10 is also the number of episodes of Home Base SPK that we have made so far. So welcome to episode 10 of Home Base SPK. And once again, from our home straight to your homes, this is Home Base SPK. Let's roll. Well, welcome everybody. I'm Uncle Yan Kai. I'm very happy to welcome you back to Home Base SPK 7th of June edition. And for today, we are going back to the Armor of God series. And today's lesson is all about righteousness. All right, everybody, before we begin praise and worship, we are going to have our opening prayer. So let's all pray. Dear God, thank you for today. Thank you for another day where we can gather together and learn about your word, and learn about your righteousness in our lives. Dear Lord, teach us to be righteous in everything that we do. All this we pray in Jesus' name, and everybody say, Amen. Okay, everybody, we begin with praise and worship. So everybody on your feet up, and here we go.
Thank you. be scared. I'll hold on to you and your promise again. I won't hide, I will not fear. Be scared.
I'll hold on to you and your promise again.
I won't hide, I will not fear. Your love ignites my way. I hold on to you today. I won't run, I won't be scared.
Boys and girls, my name is Uncle Glenn.
My name is Uncle.
And we are going to do
praise and worship.
So let's quieten our hearts and our minds.
Lord, if we could, we would fill our hands with all the wonderful things you give us. Then we'd lift them up and give them back to you.
Nicely done, everyone. Thank you, Uncle Weeping, for bringing us the new song, Love Lights the Way. Now, just because it's home-based SPK doesn't mean we can't learn new songs. Right, now, it's time for the memory verse, and so over to Auntie Susan.
Hi children! Welcome back to the Armor of God memory verse. 2 weeks ago we did the Belt of Truth. Today we do the Breastplate of Righteousness. Ready? It's taken from Ephesians chapter 6, verse 14. Let's commit all this to memory, alright? It's good for us. It's God's word in our minds, to our hearts. Ready? Go. Stand therefore, having fastened on the belt of truth, having put on the breastplate of righteousness. Ephesians 6, verse 14. Hey children, I have a guest at today's memory verse. Can you guess who is my guest? Give you a clue? Well, start with the letter B. No, not that. No. He's furry. Some more clues? He's golden brown. Yes, you're right. It's Barkley. Let's welcome Barkley.
Hello, Auntie Susan.
Welcome, Barkley, to Memory Verse. It's good to have you.
Yes.
Are you ready to learn the Memory Verse? Happy.
Okay, yes.
Yeah. Great. Dogs can learn Memory Verse too.
Oh, yes.
Sure. Children, are you ready to help Barkley do the
Memory
Verse?
Yes, please.
Ready, go. Stand therefore. Having fastened on the belt of truth, and having put on the breastplate of righteousness, Ephesians 6, verse 14. Have you got it, Barkley? Pay attention,
Okay.
Eyes on me.
Eyes on you.
Alrighty. Okay, one more time, Barkley, and then we're good.
Okay.
Barkley, you going to be with us every week?
Every week.
All through the armor of God. Pretty good. Well, I hope by the end you know the whole armor. Okay.
Yes. I shall learn everything.
Children, one more time. The memory verse, Ephesians 6, verse 14. Stand therefore, having fastened on the belt of truth, having put on the breastplate of righteousness, Ephesians 6, verse 14. Say goodbye, Barkley.
Bye-bye.
See you next week.
Thank you, Auntie Susan, and our very interesting guest. Now it's time for the Bible lesson with Pastor Richard.
All times. His praise be ever on my lips. Let those who seek the Lord will lack for no good thing. A righteous man may have many troubles, the Lord rescues him from them all. You have rescued me from the mouth of lions, and I will declare your name to my brothers in the congregation. I will praise you.
Out of my way, Daniel, servant of the living God. Has your God been able to save you?
O King, live forever. My God has sent his angel, and he shut the mouth of the lions. They have not hurt me, because I was found innocent in his sight.
Come forth.
That was Daniel. He was thrown into the lion's den by the king. He did not do anything wrong. It was the bad people who accused him and told the king that Daniel did something seriously bad. And the king threw him into the lion's den. But God kept Daniel alive. The lions, they were supposed to eat him, but they just sat quietly and went to sleep. Now, children, you and I, God has called upon us to have courage to do what is right, to stand up with what is right. You say, Pastor Richard, sometimes I'm afraid. It's okay to be afraid. Courage comes to you when you pray. Because when you pray, God takes the fear away. And you will have courage to do what is right. So today, pray that God will give you the courage to do what is right.
And now over to Auntie Li Duan for the PowerPoint.
Hello, boys and girls. Now is PowerPoint. I will guard my heart and do the right thing. Now, can you say a little bit faster? I will guard my heart and do the right thing. Now, let's try a bit faster. I will guard my heart and do the right thing. Now, let's try super fast. I will guard my heart and do the right thing.
Today's object lessons are brought to us by Uncle Derek and Uncle Weeping. So over to you, Uncle Derek, Uncle Weeping.
Hello, children. Today, we learn about Daniel. Daniel is one of the great Bible heroes. Why? Because he was courageous. He did the right thing, even if it was difficult. He was under lots of pressure to bow down to the idols. But he kept his faith in God. He did what was right, and God delivered him. So, children, where did Daniel get the strength to always do the right thing? Well, God gave him the strength. You know, children, it is not doing the right things by our own strength. If we do things by our own strength, the Bible says that is just like filthy garments. This is my work t-shirt. You find that I've had perspiration on it, dirt, and it's quite smelly, right? When we accept Jesus, He forgives our sins, and He gives us new life. That is just like this new white shirt, which I can wear to a party, okay? Now, children, don't let Satan fool you. Satan wants to fool you to think that you are just worthless and filthy clothes. But remember, you can put on the breastplate of righteousness because that is what Jesus gives us. Jesus has forgiven us. He gives us new life. So it's as though we have new clothes. We have a new life. So don't be fooled by Satan. Remember, put on the breastplate of righteousness so that you can do the righteous deeds of God to glorify Him.
Coco, wake up! It's a Sunday!
Huh? I want to sleep! Okay. Wait, 5 minutes. I play my Brawl Star. Very exciting. 5 minutes, okay? 5 minutes.
An hour later.
Ayo, mommy, I said to get ready for SPK and you're still playing Brawl Stars?
Okay. I off. You also want to play? Wait, I'll ruin my ex adventure. Treachery in the prison. Very nice. Mommy! 5 minutes, okay? 5 minutes.
Ooh. Another hour later.
Coco, sign for SDK. Are you ready?
Okay, I'm coming.
Oh no, look at your hair.
Oh, what's wrong with my hair? Oh, it's okay. Never comb for one day, it's okay. No problem. Shall we go?
Smell. Ew, don't tell me you haven't brushed your teeth.
Oh yeah, I forgot to brush my teeth.
Ew. Hey boys and girls, there are things we do by choice every day without even thinking about it. Just like combing your hair and brushing your teeth. Coco had funny hair because he didn't want to comb his hair. And he had bad breath too because he didn't want to brush his teeth. Now, God's putting on God's breastplate of righteousness is insane. We can make a choice every day to do right and to live right for God. So every morning when you wake up, make a choice. Choose to put on God's breastplate of righteousness and to do right and live right for Jesus every day.
Time for the life story, and for the life story, we're going back to Bible boot camp with the army ants. So everybody, are you ready? Let's roll. Welcome back to Bible Boot Camp, and we're joining again Itchy, Bugsy, and Dashley, the new army ant recruits. And let's see what they're up to today. Oh, it looks like they're having a briefing by Sergeant Bailey. And Sergeant Bailey is holding up a t-shirt in front of all the new army ant recruits and saying, "Okay, listen up, new recruits. This is the new army ant t-shirt, and you will be wearing it on the base and off the base at all times. Is that understood?" And all the recruits very obediently said, "Yes, Sergeant Bailey, we will wear the t-shirt all the time." And so Itchy, Bugsy, and Dashley took their t-shirts and went back to the bunk. Now, things were fine for a while, but then Saturday came, and Saturday at the Army Ants base meant off day, which meant that all the Army Ants could go into town to enjoy and relax a little bit and have a little bit of R&R, what we call rest and recreation time. So Itchy, Bugsy, and Dashley put on their t-shirts and headed out to the waiting truck outside the base. And there they saw some of the older soldiers already sitting on the truck, but they were not wearing the t-shirt. So Itchy, Bugsy, and Dashley said, "Hey guys, aren't you supposed to be wearing the t-shirts? Because Sergeant Bailey said," and the older soldiers just pointed and laughed and they says, "Would you do everything that Sergeant Bailey says? I mean, come on. We are going to town. We are not going to be wearing some t-shirt that is lame. We want to wear our normal clothes and we want to hang out with everybody. We want to look just like everyone else." And Itchy, Bugsy, and Dashley looked at each other and said, well, we are new here. Well, we better listen to the rules. So I guess we'll keep our t-shirts on. And we'll keep our t-shirts on for the trip, yeah?" So they climbed onto the truck and off they went into town. And not before long, the driver pulled up at a new place that had opened up just outside the base called Planet Picnic, made up of some strange bottles and cans. And the driver turned around and said to everybody, "Okay, everyone, this new place just opened up and I heard it's really cool. So everyone off the truck, let's go check it out and see what Planet Picnic is all about." And Iggy, Bugsy and Dashley decided that they would check it out too. Let's see what Planet Picnic was all about. And as they stepped in, a strange smell wafted over them and they said, "Whoa, wow, this place smells of beer. And what is that? Is that the smell of smoke in the air? Gosh, it does make us feel kind of uncomfortable. And look at all the bugs over here. They are some really strange looking bugs. I don't really feel comfortable around here." And at this moment, one of the older soldiers came up to the table, well, the dice, where Itchy, Bugsy and Dashley were sitting at, and they started talking to them and says, "Hey, if you want to be cool, you're gonna have to join us, huh? So you're gonna have a drink, and you're gonna light up a little smoke, and you're gonna be cool, and you're gonna hang out with us, okay?" Now, Bugsy and Dashley were really uncomfortable by this, and so they exchanged glances at each other and says, "Hey, I don't feel really comfortable about this place. What do you say we get out of here and we go back to base, huh?" So Bugsy and Dashley said, Yeah, that's what we should do. Itchy, are you with us?" But Itchy was already talking to the older soldier, and Itchy really, really wanted to be popular. So Bugsy and Dashley said, "You know, okay, let's just get out of here. Itchy, you're gonna follow us, right, Itchy?" But Itchy was too engrossed in conversation. So Bugsy and Dashley took one look behind them and says, "Well, we gotta get out of here because this place is really making us uncomfortable." But Itchy and the other older soldiers were already having a great time, and to their horror, they saw that Itchy had already turned his shirt inside out, and he was already putting his feet on the table and saying, "Ah, it's my off day. Let's live a little. After all, we've got the whole week to work in camp and we have earned our break, so it's time to kick back and relax a little." Now, Uncle Yen Kai needs to go full screen. There is something that you need to know about the breastplate of righteousness that God gives to us. You see, the breastplate of righteousness is like that Army Ants t-shirt that Sergeant Bailey told the ants to put on. When you put it on, you're wearing it all the time, on the base and off the base, meaning there are no off days where you can just take off the t-shirt and just pretend that you are not supposed to be wearing the breastplate of righteousness anymore. With righteousness, there are no off days. And if you think that you can take it off and put it on again and be righteous in church and then be another person outside of church, well, you're about to find out what's about to happen to Itchy. So let's go back to the story. So look at Itchy sitting over there, enjoying himself, living the life. Well, he was having a good time with everybody, but as the day drew to a close, everybody climbed back onto the truck and started to head back to base. But you know, everybody was already drunk, including the driver. And you know what that means, because as the driver started to make his way slowly back to camp, he took a turn a little bit too fast and oops! The truck went tumbling down the cliff. The whole truck went boom, 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 all the way down. And everybody in the truck was all knocked about and injured. And everybody was so seriously injured, they had to call the Army Ants base ambulance to come and rescue the whole lot of them. None of them were killed, but they were quite badly injured and quite badly knocked around. Some of their limbs and their antennas were broken as well, including poor Itchy. And after a few days in the hospital, a very beaten and battered Itchy climbed out and headed back to the bunk to look for Bugsy and Dashley. And as Itchy entered the room, Bugsy and Dashley stood up and looked at him and said, "Itchy, what happened to you? What happened back there? And why are you so badly injured?" Poor Itchy just looked down and said, "I don't know, guys. I guess I just forgot who I was back there. I got so engrossed in having fun and so concerned about wanting to be popular with hanging out with the rest of the soldier ants that I forgot who I was. I forgot that I was supposed to be part of the army ants and forgot that I'm supposed to be with you guys, hanging out with you guys and not with those people. But no more. I learned a painful lesson, and so from this day onwards, I am a changed ant." And so all's well that ends well for Itchy, Bugsy and Dashley, even if Itchy had to learn a very painful lesson that day. Now, what do we learn from today's story? We learned that the breastplate of righteousness is something that we put on, and there are no off days as far as righteousness is concerned. It's not like we can be righteous in church and then do our own thing outside of church. We are righteous all the time. And we also learned that we are also to hang out with the right people. We need to be around God's righteous people, because by being with the unrighteous, we can also get ourselves into trouble, as Itchy found out. So, be righteous all the time and be with God's righteous people. And that's our story for today. So come back next week for yet another installment of The Army Ants. Now over to Auntie Jackie for the closing prayer.
Let's close in prayer, children. Let's raise our hands and let's pray. Dear Lord, we thank you that your Holy Spirit will help us and guide us to always choose to do the right thing, that we will do right no matter what. Thank you, Lord, for your help and guidance in our daily lives. And Lord, we pray for your strength to lead and guide us to do the right thing. In Jesus' name we pray, and all God's children said, Amen.